The Molosser breeds are known for their wide chests, large stature, and muscled legs. This group mainly includes sheepdogs, mastiffs, and anything that derived from those two subgroups over time. Defining the word Molosser is agreed upon by most, as these dogs were named after the Molossi tribes in which these dogs originated. Because the Molosser dogs are one of the oldest known groups in the world, many dog breeds that fit into this group are controversial, as some are extinct or have been bred too many times and don't attain the physical qualities that they used to. Within the Molosser group, there are two divided groups, which are home guardians or flock guardians. In this video, we have listed today's top 10 Molossian dog breeds. Number 10, Spanish Mastiff. The Spanish Mastiff is a dog of great size, well-balanced, very powerful, and muscular. He has a massive head and a body covered with a medium-length coat. His bark is raucous, low-pitched, and deep, very sonorous and audible from a considerable distance. The Spanish Mastiff comes in a range of coat colors, including black, fawn, red, gray, and yellow, and can be seen with brindle or white markings. Used for guarding and defense, the breed is closely related to the seasonal moving of livestock, especially the Merino livestock, which he accompanied at the time of the Mesta. In the Middle Ages, this was an association of sheep ranchers who journeyed seasonally to distant locations to find grazing pastures. The Spanish Mastiff was in charge of defending them against wolves and other predators throughout their travels. Number 9, Dogue de Bordeaux. The Dogue de Bordeaux is among the several AKC breeds whose history stretches so far back into ancient times that pinpointing its exact origins is impossible. A prevailing origin tale has it that the dog's ancestors were introduced to France by Julius Caesar's conquering legions in the 1st century BC. These immense mastiff types were utilized by the Romans as both war dogs and ferocious gladiators who did battle with other dogs and wild beasts in the arena. For centuries, the Bordeaux Mastiff, or the Bordeaux Bulldog, as it was sometimes called, apparently came in two size varieties. The smaller variety, the Doggin, disappears from the historical record after the 1700s, leaving the slightly larger version as the breed we know today as the Dogue de Bordeaux. Number 8, English Mastiff. For the uninitiated, a face-to-face encounter with these black-masked giants can be startling. A male stands at least 30 inches at the shoulder and can outweigh many a full-grown man. The rectangular body is deep and thickly muscled, covered by a short double coat of fawn, apricot, or brindle stripes. The head is broad and massive, and a wrinkled forehead accentuates an alert, kindly expression. Mastiffs are patient, lovable companions, and guardians who take best to gentle training. Eternally loyal mastiffs are protective of family, and a natural wariness of strangers makes early training and socialization essential. Number 7, Caucasian Shepherd Dog. The Caucasus mountain range of Eastern Europe, so many nations with different cultures calling it their home throughout the centuries. The Caucasus mountains are also home to the Caucasian Ovcharka, or Caucasian Shepherd Dog. Although its first official Western show ring appearance was in the 1930s in Germany, the Caucasian Shepherd has existed since ancient times and was introduced to the bloodlines of many of today's world breeds throughout history. Many researches show the Caucasian dog as being a close relative of the sheepdogs of the Balkans and mastiffs of Asia. Historically, Caucasian Shepherd Dogs were used for the guarding and safekeeping of herds, flocks, and dwellings from predators. The first mention of a large molossoid dog used by the army of Armenian Tsar Tigran II dates from the 1st century BC. Number 6, Rottweiler. The Roman Empire was the organizing force behind Western Europe's formative years, and dog breeding was among the many pursuits forever altered by the Romans, genius for practical problem solving. When conquering Roman legions marched to far-flung corners of the world, they brought their herds with them as food on the hoof. The army required tough, durable dogs to move and guard the herd. Utilizing Molossi and Mastiff types as breeding stock, the Romans developed the distant ancestor of today's Rottweiler. Considering the many roles the breed has played during its long history, it is remarkable that the butcher's dog has changed little in form and temper since its first German breed standard was drawn up in 1901. Number 5. Neapolitan Mastiff. If Mastinos look like strange visitors from antiquity, it's because that's exactly what they are. The breed might go back as far as 700 BC. These majestic guardians of startling appearance are massive, powerful dogs. The U.S. Neapolitan Mastiff Club describes their dog's head as astounding, and give them credit for hitting upon just the right adjective. The profuse hanging wrinkles and folds, the pendulous lips, make a Mastino look like a marzipan mastiff that's been out in the sun too long. And yet, the breed's inner dignity and nobility can only be described as beautiful. Number 4. Pyrenean Mastiff. While the origin of the Pyrenean Mastiff is not clearly known, it is generally accepted that the breed is descended from Molosser dogs brought from Sumeria and Assyriado Spain by the Phoenicians some 3,000 years ago. Due to the remoteness of the various areas of the Pyrenees Mountains and the rest of the region now known as Spain, the original Molosser dogs developed divergently by region into several livestock guardian breeds. The Pyrenean Mastiff, the Spanish Mastiff, and the breed most closely related to the Pyrenean Mastiff, the Pyrenean Mountain Dog, which is also known as the Great Pyrenees. Number 3. Cane Corso. At the height of the Roman Empire's power, the legions that subdued and occupied the Greek islands brought Molossers back to Italy and bred them to native Italian breeds. The offspring produced by these crosses were ancestors of the modern Corso and its larger relative, the Neapolitan Mastiff. The original Corsi were used as dogs of conquest who earned their stripes as periphery, fearless dogs who charged enemy lines with buckets of flaming oil strapped to their backs. It is supposed that these early Corsi were bigger, more lumbering dogs than today's sleeker version, which moves with a cat-like grace. With the dissolution of the Western Empire in the 5th century, Italy's legions and their dogs were out of work. Corsi adapted to such civilian jobs as wild boar hunting, farming, livestock droving, and most famously, guarding farmsteads and henhouses. Number 2. St. Bernard. The St. Bernard's written standard abounds with phrases like very powerful, extraordinarily muscular, imposing, and massive. A male stands a minimum of 27.5 inches at the shoulder. In the year 1050, at a snowy pass within the Alps, a monk named Bernard of Menthon, later canonized, established a hospice to aid pilgrims journeying to Rome. At 8,000 feet above sea level, with drifts as high as 40 feet, crossing the pass was treacherous. Over several centuries, the hospice monks developed powerful working dogs, able to locate and rescue luckless travelers buried by drifts and avalanches. Number 1. Illyrian Sheepdog. The Illyrian Sheepdog is an ancient guardian breed hailing from the mountainous terrain of Balkan, or Illyria, as it was known in the Roman age. Experts believe they are one of the world's oldest native dog breeds, originating from the Molosser dogs. These large doggos had the important job of protecting and herding livestock from large, predatory animals like bears and wolves, which is probably why they're so large themselves. Later on, their large and intimidating stature made them appealing as guardians, as well as military and police dogs. But for many, many years, the breed never left their region of origin. It wasn't until the 1950s that the breed gained worldwide recognition by registering with the FCI as the Illyrian Shepherd Dog. So that's it. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Now, a question for you. What would you name this female puppy? Let us know in the comments. Here are some other cool videos I know you'll enjoy. See you later.